What's going on, guys? Pablo from Style Systems over here. For more information, go to stylesystems.net. So on this video, I want to talk about something, you know, a question that I got asked, and this is a video request. Keep sending me your video requests, keep sending me your questions, because probably if, you know, the topic is good and it works for everyone, I will do a video for it, okay? So keep sending me your questions, comment down below, and I'll be more than glad to do it. This is how to dress for a job interview. You know, if you are going to a job interview, you probably want to get the fucking job. It's just fucking obvious, right? So one of the things that you must do is you must be able to stand out through the way that you look. This is basically talking the non-verbal communication of you. Yes, you are doing a phenomenal CV, you know, like a curriculum, or I don't know how to fucking say it, you know, like the your experience, and that you put it out there on a beautiful document with a good design, and then you show off all of your experience, where you went to school and all these things. Then of course, what you say, you know, all of these things, they also play in, come into hand. But you have to agree with me that how you look is how you're going to get treated. I don't care if you have the best skills for that job, for that position. But imagine if two people apply for the same position, one of them has the best skills and more experience, and the other one has nothing, but the way one of them looks like just roll out of bed, you know, it's the breath stinks, you know, he doesn't take care of his grooming habits, like the hair, like doesn't even comb his hair. The condition of their clothes, it's a little bit, you know, like greasy and smelly, and it's a little bit more of, you know, in a bad condition. Just imagine that. And then also, imagine if just the moment, the body language of that person, just the whole presence of one of them is just go past unnoticed. You know, that person doesn't have a good handshake and doesn't look in the eye. Now, on the other hand, the other person looks very sharp. That person dressed specifically for that occasion, maybe not putting too much effort, like, you know, to show off, but he did it. He did some research, and then he put himself in the best way possible. He presented the best way, the best face, the best part of himself, and then he takes care of his body language, he takes care of, you know, visual contact and all this shit. Just imagine the impact that is going to generate on the interviewer. On the person that is going to hire them. They do pay attention to the skills and to the experience, but they also pay attention to the person itself. If you look sharp, if you brush your teeth, if you take care of your hair, if you comb your hair, if you look like someone who's well put together, grooming, you know, on your grooming habits and on your fashion as well, you are sending out a nonverbal communication. You are stimulating something inside of them. Like psychologically, you are letting them know that you have good habits. You will take care of the position. You will take care of the business. You will take care of the company in the same way that you take care of yourself. Now, I don't care if you agree with this or not, man, but it's just what happens. I did not invent the rules. This is just what happens. So that just goes to say, you know, it goes without saying that you need to pay attention to how you present yourself. Now, you should not be doing it just to be fake, just to present something that you're not, because this is what happens most of the time, you know. They present something on the interview, but then on a daily basis when they're actually on the job, they don't keep up with that standard that they presented, and this is why they lose sometimes their jobs. So let me give you some quick tips that you should be paying attention to when you are presenting yourself, and what to wear when you are on an interview, on a job interview. The first thing is, wear a suit. If you are a man, you need to wear a suit. There's no other combination that works more perfect to present yourself. It is the best code that you can present. It is the best thing that you can do. There's no other, there's no denying it. If you're a woman, you can actually wear a suit as well, with some skirt and a blazer. You can also wear a dress, a little black dress. Do your own research. If you have a little black dress, it's the best. But you need to be careful with how much skin you're going to show, because you don't want to, I mean, you want to show your femininity, but you don't want to lose their attention. You don't want them to get lost in your curves or in your body. You don't want that. then the colors that you should be wearing, they should be like sober colors, you know, like very serious colors. One is this gray, a light gray or an Oxford, or don't wear black. If you're a man, don't wear black. If you're a woman, wear a little black dress or some gray or some Oxford, maybe some navy. These colors, they work perfectly because you're showing that you're serious, you're responsible because of the psychological meaning of those colors, and basically because they are more accepted when it comes to a job interview. Now, of course, it all depends on the type of job that you want to land. It's different for a lawyer, the way that that lawyer needs to present himself, than for someone, a creative, you know, a creative director for an advertising company. It's going to be so different. That's why I emphasize that your fashion should answer to the needs of your audience. What do I mean by your audience? Well, if you are going to a job interview, you should do your research prior to that meeting. What do I mean by that? Get inside of the website of the company. If you know the name of your interviewer, get inside of his Facebook page. You know, do as much research as you can so that you can present to the best of your abilities and being in congruence with your own essence, with who you are, because remember, you don't want to be fake, but you're going to present yourself in a way that covers the needs of that interview and of that company, all right? This is the best way to do it. Then also focus on little details. I mean, you can wear a, you know, like for instance, a watch, maybe one ring, just one, like in here, just one, you don't want to overdo it. Maybe if you're wearing a suit, you want to wear a tie clip, you know, things like that that make you stand out, because that's the second part. You want to stand out. You want to be different. Imagine how many people are applying for the same position, for the same fucking job, and how many people they actually went to the same high school or to the same university, to the same place, they know, they have the same experience. So what do you have to offer? What is so different about you? That's why you need to communicate without any words. You don't want to be there and just brag about yourself and say, hey, I'm the best because this is, and you start explaining yourself. The moment you explain yourself, you already lost. You want to show off everything that you treasure, everything that you are all about, you know, what your values, the values that represent you. You want to present them without even speaking. How? Through your body language, through your presentation, through the implementation of little details. That's how you can do it. Because even if you have a bunch of people wearing the same outfit, the way that you're gonna stand out is through the accessories and little details. And last but not least, make an impression. I mean, you have to look for a part. If you're looking to land a job as a manager, look like a manager. You don't wanna look like an employee, no? You wanna look like a CEO. If you are applying for a position of a CEO, look for the part. I mean, you have no idea how they correlate. You think that they don't go together because you want to be, you don't want to get judged and all these things, but they happen. Whether you want them or not, they're still going to happen. They've been happening forever, and they're still going to happen. So dress for the part that you want. Dress for the part. Actually, that actually works both ways. Because the moment you dress for that part, it's like your inside, your mind buys that idea, and you even like, you know, you feel better about yourself, like, oh shit, I am that CEO. So that's going to permeate your entire communication, because in your subconscious mind, you already believe it, you buy that idea that you are someone who is powerful, you know, wear things that empower you, wear things that, you know, it's like wearing the cape of a superhero. They don't need that cape to be a superhero, but the moment they wear it, it's like there's something different about them, right? This is how you should do it. Make an impression, because you will get treated in the way that you look. This is just what it is, okay? If you look like someone who doesn't care about himself, and if you look like someone who's not well put together, they're gonna treat you like that. And why shouldn't they? The inside should be, and the outside, they go together. The outside should be a representation of what's going on the inside. And then the inside should, you should project it on the outside as well. You should not keep it on the inside. If you're happy, if you are a very stable, responsible, reliable, powerful leader, you should communicate it on the outside as well. You should not be, you know, walking around with a billboard saying, I am a leader. No, you want to do it through your nonverbal communication, don't you? So pay attention to that and find a way within your niche, within your profession, to make an impression. That's the way that they're going to remember you. whether it's with your business card, whether it is with your, you know, the curriculum, or I don't know how to say it in English, pardon me, with the, you know, the experience folder that you present to them, and even the way that you look, you want to leave an impression so that they can remember you. The moment you leave that room, they will remember, like, I remember this fucking mustache guy, man. Like, no one else showed up in the way that this person did. I guarantee you, if you cover these steps and if you implement them, they will remember you. And even if you don't land the job, at least they will tell you why you didn't, you know, and you will still create a reputation about you. Maybe you didn't land that job, but maybe you will land another one. So this is just a good habit overall. So with that, I'm gonna leave you. Keep sending me your questions, man. Keep sending me your comments and your video requests. I fucking love it. Become the best version of yourself and take care of your image. See you in the next one.